בעזרת השם, we are starting the book of Bereshit. Bereshit, it is the beginning. The Torah speaks about the beginning of the creation. Now, Rambam opens in the halachot of Yesodei HaTorah, the halachot of the foundation of the Torah, is that everyone, before anything, needs to understand and to know and to believe that the foundation and the foundation of all the wisdom, the foundation of everything, the foundation of any belief that a person will have, the first thing is to believe that Hashem, that God, is the one who created the world, is the first of the first. It means before Hashem, before God, nothing was existing before God. It means God was before, God is in the present, and God will be in the future. It means if you have any other belief that God was created by certain time, so God cannot be God, because God cannot have a beginning. God has no beginning, has no end. What has end, what has beginning? It is something that is created. Hashem Yitbarach, God, is not created. Hashem Yitbarach is before any time existed. Now, this is a very important foundation for everyone, for us to know and to understand. Now, there is another point which it is very important for every one of us to know. Okay, we are all having questions. Take any person, we have questions. We can ask questions about the creation. We can ask questions. We are born to ask questions. For every question that any one of us will ask, there is an answer. But we have to understand, if we look at ourselves, the steps that we are going through of our life, we are going to see that the answers that we got 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, 4 years ago, these answers was good, was that satisfies us 20 years ago, 30 years ago. That now, these answers, we see more we develop, more chokhmah we have, more wisdom we have, we see that the questions stays always. The answers always become, oh, but this answer is not good anymore for me. I need a better answer. You stay with your questions. So now, let's go and try to do investigation, and let's try to go deep, to understand the creation. To go, and we have to understand, as much that we are going to ask questions, and as much that we are going to go and dig to understand the creation, more and more questions are going to appear. More and more we are going to find ourselves that we are asking questions, and we're getting to actually a black hole. We see how much we don't know. And we see this with big science, that when they go to questions that when they don't have an answer, what they say? I don't know. Or there is God. Then they, sometimes for them it is very, very hard to admit, oh yeah, I don't understand, because they don't understand. So I don't understand. If I don't understand, there is no God. No, it doesn't work like that. Hashem made this world. Hashem, God, created this world for us not to understand everything. Yes, we can have a lot of questions, but it doesn't mean that we are going to have answers for the questions that we have. Now, of course, questions we have in this life, in this world. If you have questions after 120 years, when a person goes to the Shamayim, there is no questions over there. You know, there is a story with Aramban, Aramban, Alav HaShalom. Ramban, one of his students that passed away very young. And Ramban was devastated because this student was a big Talmid Chacham, he was genius. And Ramban always was saying that this student, he will become one of the biggest tzaddikim in that generation. And he passed away very young, in the 20s. And Ramban was very upset, and he said, what is this? I thought that this great student is going to become a great, big scholar. And now I see that this great person that I thought that he will become a great scholar, he passed away. It was very hard for Ramban to understand. So Ramban, he made She'elat Chalom, it is a question in a dream. He asked the question, and by the dream, the night, the student came to Ramban. So Ramban started to ask him questions about the heavens and how things happening in heavens and etc. and etc. And Ramban said to him, I did ask you a question, why you passed away so young. I needed an answer because I thought and I counted on you that you are going to become a big scholar. So the student started to laugh and he said to Ramban, you know, it's unbelievable. When I passed away, yes, I felt that when I passed away, I was very, very young. And I wanted to ask the question when I got to the Bedin, when I got to my judgment, I really wanted to ask the question why I passed away very young. But I found something unbelievable up there in the sky. When I reached to the Bedin to get judged, I found out that all of a sudden, there is no question up in the Shamayim. There is no questions. Up there, there is only answers. It means the questions, they belong to people. Here on earth, we can come and ask a lot of questions, but up there is only answers. Pashut, very simple. There is no questions because over there you see the clarity. There is only clarity. Now, we have to understand something very, very, very important about emunah, about faith. Of course, to have faith, the most important faith is, okay, not to know what was before. For me to know what was before, okay, let's assume now I know what was before. Does this will bring me to have faith? We know, okay, the rabbis will go and give us all the correct answers. Let's the science to give us all the correct answers. If I will know the correct answers, or if the world will know the correct answers, all the correct answers, that will make us to be better people, good people, or this will make us to return to God? Not necessarily. If I will know the present, all my present, you know, everything we do in our present. Let's assume now they are going to describe us all the present time. If I will know all the present time, if I will know every second what is going to be happening in the present time, where this will take me? It will give me a faith? It will change something? Not necessarily. If I will know the future about everything, let's imagine that we know every moment what will be the future. If we were going to know the future of every moment, that will bring us more faith, or you think that is going to change something? No, because you know what? We have something in our DNA. It is when a person gets used to things. When people get used to things, and you know, unfortunately, and I always say, our biggest enemy is the routine. When imagine yourself that you know all your past, it is a routine that you know everything that the past. It is a routine. The routine brings you to a moment that you don't really think anymore. The past is nothing anymore because it is a routine. The present, every present that you know, it becomes a routine. Then you don't pay attention to it. The same thing is the future. If imagine that you will know the future, you will know every second will be the next second. It will take us to a place of a routine that we are not going to look anymore to understand the future. So the message of here, and I think the most important message for every one of us, is to have a faith. But the faith is not because I know or I need to know everything. It's the faith that we have to know. It's simple faith. You know, let me tell you a Hasidic story. I heard about the Baal Shem Tov, Alav Shalom. Baal Shem Tov went, you know, Baal Shem Tov was traveling everywhere. And one of his trips, he went to an hotel. And he saw the owner of the hotel that he prays in the morning. He has the book of the prayers, and he sees him reading the entire book of the prayer. He sees him saying Modeh Ani, and he finish Aleinu Leshabeach of Shacharit, then he start Lamenatzeach, then he is doing Aleinu Leshabeach of Milcha, then he's doing Birkat Hamazon, the blessing of the food, then he's doing Arvit, and everything that the book say, he finish every prayer, the entire book. So the Baal Shem Tov said to him, "What are you doing?" He said, "You know, I'm praying to God, and whatever I'm doing, it's I'm reading the entire book. You know, the entire book. I'm reading it. That's what I'm doing." So the Baal Shem Tov said, "You know, it's not like that. You know, every tefillah, every prayer has a portion. You can't just do the entire book." So the Baal Shem Tov says, "You know, I'm going to teach you how is every portion of the prayer books goes. There is Shacharit, okay, there is Mincha, there is Arvit, there is Birkat Hamazon, there is prayers, etc., etc." The next day, Baal Shem Tov, he woke up very early in the morning and he went to his trip. He forgot to teach this simple man how to pray. You know, Rabotai, listen to this. This simple man woke up in the morning and he see the Baal Shem Tov left, but he didn't teach me how to pray. You know, when the Baal Shem Tov reached to the river, he came to the river, and the simple guy is running after the Baal Shem Tov, and he yells and screams, "Baal Shem Tov, Baal Shem Tov, you didn't teach me, hey, hey, hey." Now, the Baal Shem Tov reached to the river, he didn't hear this person calling him. Baal Shem Tov had a towel. He just put it on the water. He put himself on top of the towel, and the towel was moving. He was moving. Now this guy, he sees the Baal Shem Tov, what he's doing. He's running after Baal Shem Tov. He had a piece of cloth in his hand. He put it on the water. He went on top of it, and the waves was taking Baal Shem Tov and this simple person. And he reached to the Baal Shem Tov, and he yells and he screams, "Baal Shem Tov, Baal Shem Tov, you know, you promised me that you're going to teach me to pray." Now Baal Shem Tov is turning, and he sees this man floating, the same like him. Now, Baal Shem Tov, to do it, he had to have certain knowledge, names of angels. He had to know so many things before he took the towers and to put it on the water and to be floating on the water. Now, this simple person, no names of angels, no name of nothing, is just simple Jew, simple person. He's doing exactly the same thing like the Baal Shem Tov. Baal Shem Tov, he looked at him, he said, "You know, if I see you that you're doing what I'm doing, and I need to use names and of angels, and you don't need to use any names of angels, it's mean that you're doing correct. You're praying in the correct way, and continue to do the same thing that you do everything, finish the entire book." So we see sometimes to get to reach to very high levels, you don't need to do much, and you don't need to be just simple faith. Simple faith. We can continue to have questions, but to know that not every question we can have the answer. Yes, there is an answer. The answer is, yes, there is an answer, but maybe the answer that I will receive today will satisfy me. Maybe in 10 years from now, it's not going to satisfy me. And we are going, and remember, everyone, remember yourself. Since you know yourself, you have always the same questions and the same answers that you got before. They don't satisfy you anymore. So we never get satisfied by anything. So the only things that will make us satisfied is simple faith, simple emunah, and Be'ad Hashem will be in the best place. Amen, amen, and amen.